So, we need three buffs, one Oakling buff, a Toad. That's 19 damage always, and then something extra. Don't really care what that extra thing is. So I kind of feel like blue is one of the harder matchups with all the small tokens. They also yeah, maybe general monocolor decks because they just can make more prayers all the time. Fun and think they're active. He burns me with 18 damage. Yeah, but he could have also won that. If he had just one blue creature, he just prevents. I mean, with the hand and the things I draw, I could have killed one creature and then finish him with the other Toad. But I mean, there's a reason this deck is not tier 1. And you can sometimes win a game with it. Like, but it would be much worse if everybody on ladder would play this deck and it would be the best. I don't think that's a reason to complain about the deck because it's not interactive, because it's also not good. Should go away from him. I don't Wisdom because I want to wind, be able to Windfall. Next turn it would be sweet, Wisdom into Windfall into Earthcraft. Into another Windfall, stuff like that. Yes, probably stepping on it makes sense, yeah. It's definitely Wisdom here. Oh, that's the Windfall. But no Earthcraft. So it means he can block with a green creature. I don't really want to cycle Shifting Tides for Earthcraft. I guess we can wait one more turn. There's no reason to do anything now. The only way we can mill a card is via Storyteller, which he is not running in this list. So we don't have to play the Windfall. Wow. Double neutral. And he gave us the land, that's good. In case we draw an Earthcraft, we can jump up and make another land for attacking. Okay. Start with Windfall. Oakling Feed? We have no experiment, so I don't really want to search for it. And we don't need to kill our creature, we just make her big. Because it's green. Should be hard for him. Do we want to Shifting? Or do we want to keep it for later? We have only two buffs. I think I want to draw with Shifting. I could also cycle the enchantment on his creature. Maybe that's actually better. Because we have the Pharaoh. Wisdom seems good. We have enough Pharaoh. Oakling? Oh yeah, that's sweet. I like that. Oh, it buffed the right one. So how much damage is it now? Double buff? Hey, that's lethal. Hey, that's lethal. So yeah, sometimes the things just work. I think I played that one fine. Like, there were many small decisions. Using the enchantment to cycle was pretty good, I think. There. That's if you draw the cards in the right order, then it's nice. So yeah, that's actually nice. So Toad has two. Double Oakling buff is 12. You always have to count the health, not the attack of the Toad. So we count the health. Toad 2 health, double Oakling buff is 12. And then two buffs from the green cards. From Elderwood or the Shamanic Dance, that's 8. So it's actually very important to have the Oaklings. Because Oaklings, that's why I like the idea of running Fate Experiment. Because Oaklings are twice as good as Elderwoods, because you only need two Oaklings, two buffs. Otherwise you need four buffs, one Oakling. all people left because of Scumbag Orchid case. You guys have seen, you have seen me lose before the, so I might even want to keep Oakling then, but maybe that's just bad. But yeah, it's not like this deck is OP because it has a good win rate. It's just sometimes that it works. Oh no, Hunter knows what's coming. Let's see how well he can play around if he knows from turn one what's going to happen here. Green red, I kind of like that matchup. Against green red you have so much time. Like green red is one of these really typical control decks. Very slow defensive. And that's where you want to play combo decks against. You just have to time and can do your things. And if they're green red, they don't even have a hard remover. So we're waiting with Earthcraft until we're at 5 colored lands probably and want to make a 6th with the Earthcraft. We're not in a rush against green red. If you draw like last game, you win against anything. Yeah. Maybe. I don't know. I have to admit I drew pretty well there. That's true. Actually, Hunter is smart. He should have never told anyone his snail. And then he can just stream snipe all the time with his snail account. When he's still Hunter in chat. it's too early, we need one more turn, I would say. He's actually not blocking, he just wants to race, that's interesting. I don't think that's the right strategy, I don't think it's so at all. So we can even set up the lake here and have yeah, we can totally block him out. I don't think he really understands how he should play this matchup. Because next turn is going to be brutal. Wow, wow. It's going to be brutal. Come on, windfalls. Windfall now. No, I need windfalls. Well, or we don't draw a ninja toad on the windfall. Feels bad, man. Feels bad, man, with the gun. No, that's too late. I needed you earlier. What else can we do here now? He can play maybe dash creature, we can definitely wait. Do I even care if I mill any card? I have, how much damage is this? This is so much damage, but I want the Oaklings. But I don't want to waste fairy on anything. Maybe I just go for the part combo, like how much damage can you do? I can... I can only health buff it twice, I don't like that. Health buffing it twice, I could hit in with a 3-10. Doesn't seem that smart. That was maybe a mistake. To move this land. What do I... That actually helps him to dash on my lands, right? But he, unless he has land generation, he can't warstorm. So where should I have moved this then? I don't care about the taunt. I have feet and I have one tech for attacking. Was it good to... It's so good that we land blocked him, but... Well, he's not dashing on my lands. We should be able to kill him next turn. I could have played it at the well, yeah. Then he can use removal and stuff. Maybe could have also hit in. But I was afraid he would do some things. So now we draw. Draw Oakling. We need Oakling. All the enchantments. Okay. We have so many draws. Okay. Okay. In worst case, I can feed my toad. In best case, we draw Oakling and win. Okay. It was close. It was closer than it should have been, I think. Why did it go so close? Was the pushing a bad idea? He could have also played the taunt there, so there's no difference.